How's it going, everyone? My name is Puunyo. Today, we'll be taking a close look at an agent that can make huge plays for the team from his utility kit, his kill potential, and his ability to self-sustain after he's taken fights against his enemies, Phoenix. In this video, we'll be covering topics ranging from basic information about his abilities, hidden mechanical details behind each one, and also how to maximize your efficiency when you're using them. There's also going to be a bonus section where I show you guys Molotov lineups. It's something you guys can use to help your team clear corners without having to check them. Because this video covers a lot of information, I'll provide a timestamp down in the comment section below just to help you all with easier navigation. I worked hard on keeping this video as short and informative as I could, so please feel free to let me know down in the comments if you guys have any feedback. And if you guys do enjoy this video, I would appreciate it if you give it a like to support the channel, and maybe even subscribe if you're interested in seeing more. With that, let's jump right into it. So for the newer people who might not know who Phoenix is, or what exactly his abilities do, I'll do a quick overview of them. So the first ability is the curveball. The reason it's called a curveball is because it can only be curved to the left or right. It's not something that you can normally throw straight across like many of us might be used to. As long as they see the curveball, it'll flash your opponent for a short duration. The second ability is the hot hands ability, which is an equivalent of what a Molotov is. It burns the ground, and at the same time, it can also heal you if you stand in it. The third ability is blaze, which is a large firewall that blocks off vision on both sides and damages anyone that steps into the wall. And just like your Molotov, you can use this to heal up as well. And the last ability, his ultimate, is called Run It Back. And so this ultimate allows you to send a clone of yourself and leaves behind a marker that your character will spawn back into once your ultimate duration form comes out, or if you're killed in your ultimate form. Now let's take a closer look at each of them. Alright, so let's start with Curveball. This flash duration, at its full potential, lasts for 2 seconds. In order for anyone to get flashed, they have to see the flash go off. This factor opens up the Curveball for several possibilities. If you were to use character abilities like your wall or Viper's wall, or even obstacles like Brimstone Smokes and Omen Smokes, you can actually flash to your advantage. A very sneaky tactic is to use these abilities as a type of screen. You quietly position yourself behind these abilities and stand close to the edge. If an enemy is looking at the smoke's direction, or the wall's direction, or whatever it may be, which they usually are, they'll be flashed for the full duration. As soon as it pops, you have the element of surprise to kill them before they can react. The second is that if players turn away before the flash pops, they'll only be flashed for half a second and will have enough time to fight back. This also applies to you and your team if the enemy has the Phoenix, so make sure to stay on your toes to counter his flash. And third, I can't really tell you guys how many times I've seen Phoenix players accidentally hard flashing their own teammates when they're trying to make a play, and this has been going on since the day one of beta. Teammate vision matters too, yo. To stop that from happening, guys, what you should do when playing with your team is curve the flash behind where you guys are trying to peek. That way you guys will receive a partial flash, but enemies will still be flashed for the full duration. Our next ability is the Hot Hands ability, or the Molotov, which can heal you up to about 45 HP, but overall I would recommend using this more of a DPS tool. This Molotov does 45 damage per second and lasts for a total of 4 seconds, making it twice as strong as Brimstone's, but only lasting half as long. This means that pre-mollying areas to flush out enemies is a quick option when you can't afford to check every corner safely. Unfortunately, this Molotov has a radius of about 25 to 30 meters from where you throw it before it instantly flops to the ground. And it doesn't really matter how high you throw it either. You're limited to what you can molly off, but you can still make this mechanic work to your favor. Now, because this is the most fire in-depth guide for Phoenix, I got you guys on really useful molly lineups for each map that I'll show you towards the end of the video. So don't worry about that, you guys. Next up, we have Blaze, Phoenix's firewall that can extend up to 20 meters long and last for 7 seconds. Like the Molotov, this ability can heal you for up to 69 damage. Yep, 69. However, the most efficient use for this wall is as a screen to block vision. There's a couple things to note here. Many of you may not be aware of this, but you can actually curve your wall instead of leaving it as a straight line. All you have to do is hold your left mouse button once you've started throwing the wall and move the mouse in the direction that you want it to curve. This provides the flexibility of your wall in terms of areas that you want to block off, just like in this clip. You can do so without putting yourself in a dangerous spot compared to if you were trying to set up a wall regularly. Another thing is that it's possible to wall over boxes, walls, and other environmental features as long as you aim above it. Just know that the higher you have to aim, the shorter the wall length will become. And this is something that you can play around with so that you get a better understanding of what walls are safe for you to put out and what it can block off for you. Since this is Phoenix's way of safely blocking vision, make sure to take advantage of these mechanics. Lastly, we have the ultimate, Run It Back, which lasts for 10 seconds before the duration expires, so it should give you enough time to get some entry frags without actually dying. Just some quick pointers for this ability is one, to make sure that you ult in a safe spot and not in the open, because when you spawn back at your marker, there's gonna be a 1 second animation where you can't move, and that's usually more than enough time for an enemy to kill you. Always tuck yourself in a corner or behind a wall so you can prevent yourself from being an easy kill once you respawn. Two, if you're about to die from something like a raised grenade because you got trapped in a corner or by like something like a brimstone ultimate or you couldn't defuse the bomb in time, it can be worth it to pop your ultimate in order to stay alive. As long as you know that your marker will be safe from immediately being killed by an enemy, you can use it to maintain player advantage or also just to save your gun if your economy isn't looking too good. With all these mechanics covered, unlocking Phoenix's potential should be a lot easier for you. Learning about an agent is only half the battle though. Aim, game sense, and a lot of other factors also matter if you're going to play Phoenix at a higher level. I plan to make videos on these in the future as well as other agent guides when I get comfortable with each one myself. Let me know in the comments what you guys would want to see. Now, as promised in the video, I'll show you Molly lineups that could help catch opponents off guard. Use these when you're a couple rounds into the game, and you might notice patterns in where the enemies like to hold. These aren't always meant to kill someone, but it'll force them out so you won't have to check those corners when you do push out. Remember to give this video a like if you enjoyed it, and subscribe if you'd like to see more. I'll let the rest of the video play through and leave you to see the Molly spots now. Until then, take care, friends. Peace.